My light's going out. We're going to need another flashlight here in a second.
On a property in South Houston, a team from the Houston SPCA is involved in a major operation to round up hundreds of animals.
I got a rooster right on top.
Police have locked down the scene where over 100 people were being held hostage by armed men.
What was our next number?
Work has been going on for several hours in difficult conditions.
Not a lot of air circulation in here. It obviously doesn't get cleaned at all. It's just really dirty. A lot of animals in here, a lot of debris flying out, poop all over the place from the chickens, so it's kind of crazy.
We've been out here for about 4 hours now. We're a little bit halfway, maybe a little bit more in the shed. I haven't been up to the front part of the property to see how far they are up there. But we're moving as fast as we can with the amount of birds that are inside.
To make matters worse, it's now pitch black.
Can you come up here and start this generator? My flashlight went dead. The flashlights are going dead. And
the property is littered with rubbish, feces, and other hazards. Tara Yerkshat is overseeing the operation.
These conditions are awful. What you can't see here is the smell. And it's not just the smell of animal waste, but it's the smell of raw sewage. Some of the stuff that's on the ground are essentially dangerous. They're tools or they're weapons, depending on how you want to see them.
And there's poop on top.
You know, the conditions inside the coops, as soon as an animal starts moving around and fluttering, it's bringing up all the dust and debris that's at the bottom. So our team is breathing in all of that dust.
I am hot and tired and ready to breathe some fresh air.
Moving the roosters is especially unpleasant work.
There's a couple of them that are pecking. As you can see right here, they're trying to get at you. They're not happy that we're here to remove them. But we're doing our best to be able to be real careful.
No.
One of the biggest challenges is safety. You need to really keep an eye on the team and make sure they're staying hydrated, make sure they're getting a rest when they need it. A lot of these guys don't always think about themselves first, and so they want to push through, and we need to keep an eye on each other. We're a team.
Many of the birds are in poor condition.
Several of them look thin. We've had a couple that have been look like they've been plucked by the other birds, you know, pecked at, with like, looks like sores on them, missing feathers. The conditions are dirty, the water's filthy. It's just not a really good situation in there.
It's 1 a.m. and the team has been working for over 7 hours. There are far more animals on the property than they first believed.
I'm thinking what we'll do is, this first trailer is full, go ahead and send it. Because our original plan for housing these has, it's
changed
upside down. So, you know, I want us to be making adjustments back at the shelter while we've got people who are fresh.
Gonzalez heads back to the Houston SPCA, the huge trailer filled with hundreds of animals.
Well, I think we're in the home stretch. We've sent the first vehicle back to the Houston SPCA where we'll start offloading. And we're finishing up, just then get them on the truck, take a final look around, and head for home.
There are only a few more chickens to catch, but still two geese to deal with. Last off the property is an opossum found in a trap in poor health.
Guess let's try her this way.
At the Houston SPCA, Gonzalez has returned with the first load of animals.
We're trying to set them up right now. The roosters in individual cages to make sure that they don't fight with each other, and then the hens, we're putting them in groups of 10, and there's still more to come back, so.
It's 2 a.m., and over 400 animals have been successfully removed from the property. The fate of the alleged traffickers and their hostages is now in the hands of the authorities. But for the Houston SPCA, there is still a huge task ahead.
This is a whole shelter operation, so the field services part of it is done. But the work at the shelter is just starting. They'll have an opportunity tonight to calm down the birds who, you know, their world has been fairly disrupted. And starting tomorrow is the beginning of daily feeding, cleaning, and our veterinary staff will be involved at that point, looking at these animals and assessing their medical conditions.